everybody to take a minute. We're going to do a quick visualization exercise. I want you all to just close your eyes for a second. Don't feel awkward about it, because I want you to think about the goal that you're working towards. To think about how excited it is you're going to be when you have the pride and confidence in yourself that comes from the courage and self-confidence of being a self-fulfilling, healthy, fit person. The person that you want to be. Every single day you walk up to a person that you want to make proud. I want you to think about it. I want you to feel it. And I want every single one of you to remember the story of Amy Barnes. Okay? That woman is pure inspiration for everyone here. You've never, never met a woman that's got a better attitude after being cut open, tortured for 3 days, and kicked out onto the curb in front of a hospital with nobody to care for her. But she stood before each and every one of you in front of that assembly and said, yes, you can. We're going to help you along those ways. We want you to be happy inside and out, ladies and gentlemen. And I'm going to ask you throughout the day today, what's your inside goal? What's your outside goal? And I want that inside goal to be the first thing that y'all think about when it feels too tough to get up that hill. When it feels like maybe you can't pull another push-up together. When it feels like you just want to give up. What's your inside goal? What's your outside goal? What's your inside goal? What's your outside goal? Inside, outside, inside, outside. I want y'all to come in with me, all right? We want to get hands in the middle. Are we ready? Oh, we're going to feel the love. It's all about the teamwork. All about the love. Everybody in. We love this. All right, on three, inside out. One, two, three.
Inside out!
Hi, and welcome to the award-winning Ed Brown Show. Once again, we got an outstanding show. And we have a veteran here. It's the Job Corps in the Washington, D.C. area. And we have the chairman here, the director, rather, Bryant Nebbia.
Yes.
And Bryant, tell us a little something more about this program we have here. It's talking about exercising,
right.
Losing weight.
Right.
Everybody out there need to listen to this, because fitness is one thing everybody needs.
Sure.
Okay.
Thank you very much. How did
Job Corps get involved with the fitness?
Yeah, well, thank you very much, first of all, for having us here on the program. And I'm Bryant Nebbia. I'm business community liaison in charge for public relations and community outreach for the center. And we've been very lucky to get in touch with Amy Barnes, who is the CEO and the president of In-N-Out Fitness Program. Since August of last year, we have initiated a great program at the center for our students and the staff members. And we had over 50 people engaged in the program, which pretty much was a free time activity, the exercise, and working on the exercise for your physical and mental.
Now this is mandatory, or you volunteer?
Oh, it's 100% volunteer, but mm-hmm. We had so many students and staff participating.
You have more students than you have instructors, is that right?
Oh, absolutely, yes. And it's been a success since last year, and we're continuing working with Amy Barnes, and today she's here as well, and she'll be talking to the audience about the program that she does, and we at the center are always welcome to see positive changes, and she definitely brought a delightful change here on the center.
Mm-hmm. Good. Now, as far as the What's the limitations involved? You have an age limitation, or
there is no age limitations. It's open for our students and staff.
And staff.
That includes
That's
you. Right. Absolutely.
And you take part in the program.
Well,
right?
I did.
A little part of it.
A little part. I can't say that.
Set an example.
I can't really say that I lost a lot of weight, but it affected me in a very positive way to see how engaged the students and staff were together right. in that program.
Okay, yes. Then we'll get it from Ashley.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, welcome to the Ed Brown Show.
Tell us something,
how did you get involved with the Job Corps and the fitness program?
Well, I'm a student at Job Corps, Potomac, and I got involved because I needed to make myself more marketable in the job world today, and I needed some help and some affiliations with people that would be able to help me find a job and to help me out there.
And what job are you aspiring to fill?
An office administration position.
Mm-hmm. That deals with computers, right?
Yes.
Yes. You like computers.
Yes,
right?
I like them.
Right. Well, what about your, you have brothers and sisters? You better mention them. They see you on here. They see you didn't even mention them.
I have two younger sisters. I'm the oldest one.
Is that right? Yeah. So you're setting a good example.
Yes.
Right.
I'm setting a good
example. Because Job Corps has one of the best programs in the country.
Yes, they do.
And Brian and the director and all the people there, I've been out to some of the programs, and they really, in this fitness thing, I was talking to Brian about it. Mm-hmm. I said, everybody needs that, you know. I get involved in that. Every morning go out and work out, you know, and sit in the hot tub as a reward. But
sure.
Well, now, Brian, now, mm-hmm. this program, when you actually decided to get it, the student, do you have any reward for them? You know, when a person, you know, do something, do they get, the reward is losing weight. Is mm-hmm. that it?
The reward is losing weight. We also had,
improve your health.
Fitness In and Out. They provided some rewards for the first, second, and the third places.
Okay.
We'll
talk to Amy.
She will be able to give you better details on mm-hmm. how it worked. But ever since we started this program, we saw a huge improvement in behavior of students as well.
Right.
Improvement in their, they had their set schedule now, mm-hmm. where they knew that on their free time, they have an important lesson to go to, mm-hmm. To exercise and communicate with the peers and have their goal. Mm-hmm. Goal in their lives, besides getting their education settled, it's also getting their weight in control.
Mm-hmm.
So it's been working out very well, and we're very excited to have Amy Barnes on center.
But basically, they should make the mandatory for the staff. They have to set an example.
And you'd be surprised how many staff members are engaged.
Mm-hmm.
You'd be surprised because for staff members, it's also, first of all, it's a great opportunity to lose weight. And second of all, it's opportunity to get in better communication with students.
Well,
to be in the same room, exercise, and follow the same directions as students do.
Right. Mm-hmm. Well, I know you got Tony, my friend.
That's right.
Tony, he comes out at 5:30 and works out.
So
he's been inundated with the idea, the value mm-hmm. of exercise.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And that's one thing. I think it's very important people to understand. They look at other things, they put it before exercise. But really, exercise is the primary thing that makes you feel better, think better,
exactly.
And you mentally.
Mm-hmm.
People don't realize the mental aspects of fitness.
Sure, sure. And only people who went through the dramatic changes, as did Amy Barnes, can really feel through the whole pain and that huge success and the feeling of that success when you lose weight and you, now in her case, she actually made a business out of mm-hmm. that, and now she's a president of the company.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, she'll come out here and she'll be talking. It's just on my behalf, I want to see that we all at the center, we saw how much change she brings.
Mm-hmm.